Duke enters the NCAA tournament, losing back-to-back games, which I haven't checked the history books, but feels like that's the first time in a while. Historically, they play very well in the ACC tournament. They have won three of them since 2016. Not the case this year. They're coming in a little beat up with injuries to Caleb Foster and trying to rebound quickly. They get the America East champs, Vermont, in the first round, the 13 seed, who has really made a name for themselves in the conference over the past decade. I'm Riley Davis of Heat Check CBB. I'm joined by Subbi of Theater and College Hoops. We're on the Sleepers Media YouTube channel, breaking down every game in March Madness this year. Subbi, how you doing, man?
I'm good. It's so good to be paired up with you. Now, that's no disrespect to Brian Ralph, who I've loved and enjoyed working with. I'm just glad that I'm going to be bouncing around the Sleepers family here. So this is great, Riley. How are you, man?
I'm doing well. Like you said, it's actually the first time we've been able to collab for one of these preview videos. So I'm excited to talk hoops with you because I know the man Subbi, he is always up to date on the closest games around the country. It doesn't matter if it's the power conference teams ranked in the top 10 or if it's those low majors in the 300s. If you want to know when a close game is going on, you better follow his account. But that's why I'm excited to talk a little bit about Vermont. Again, I teased it in the intro. They have dominated the America East really throughout the past decade. Do you think they stand any sort of chance against Duke?
Riley, they run the America East with an iron fist. I'm from the Massachusetts area. I actually grew up about 20 minutes away from UMass Lowell. So the last couple of years, I've been like really rooting for UMass Lowell to get it done. They just can't do it. All of that said, no, I do not see Vermont beating Duke or upsetting Duke. I'm sorry. Now look, Duke, as you had mentioned, losers of two straight. They have not looked good for the last week or so. I think a lot of the fan base and a lot of those that are watching are saying, like, there's no fire. There's no energy. You get Carolina at home to share a conference championship with them, and you basically get beat soup to nuts like you did the first time in the Dean Dome. And then you say, okay, let's redeem ourselves in DC. And then you're going up against an inferior opponent, what we thought was an inferior opponent in NC State, and they laid another egg. Like, it's not as if they lost these games down the stretch or anything. They just were playing a lot of catch up the whole time. But I think Duke just has a little bit too much firepower here, Riley. And I'm going to go into some of the details, what I think the differences are. But to answer your question, I don't see an upset. How about you?
Yeah, that's where I'm at as well. I think we can talk a few of the keys to victory for Vermont if they were to do the unthinkable. I more so see this maybe staying close for the first 10 minutes of the first half before Duke goes on their run. Carolina fans across the country like myself will probably be licking their chops a little bit if it starts out like a slow, ugly game, because I think that is the main key to victory for Vermont. They slow tempo down a ton. They control the glass. They have someone in Shamir Bogues who can pressure the ball, who can get up into a guard's grill. And you know, I see him being able to bother someone like Jeremy Roach again for maybe part of the game, probably won't last the whole game. Only problem is Duke has two other really good guards that they can turn to create offense, to get big time shots. And again, with Vermont slowing the pace, maybe they can keep Duke out of transition a little bit. But I just see once that flurry starts, it's hard to stop. It could be a Jared McCain three in transition that ignites a run or punctuates a run. Jeremy Roach usually contributes to that as well, because, you know, I get that Duke, they theoretically might be best like inside out or going to Filipowski first and running through him. But, you know, in my opinion, as someone who cheers for Duke's arch rival, what scares me the most about them is when I start to see those transition threes fall.
Yeah, I think you make a lot of great points. First of all, let me unpack that a bit. Is there anything better than at the 15:45 mark, right, of the first half? It's like 4-3. And you're like, you know, if they keep this up for the remaining 36 minutes, we might have a stew going right now.
Right.
So you're just like, that was a great start. I tend to agree with you. There's going to be a bit of feeling out. I was actually talking about it on our podcast, how there's so many different contributing factors as to why all teams may be uncomfortable in their first game. Tighter rims. I don't know. The net might be shorter than what you have in your own gym. The ball might be bouncing a little differently. So I wouldn't be surprised if we saw a slow start from both Duke and Vermont. As it relates to keys for Vermont, I think you hit on a lot of great points. They're very solid defensively, and they're good on the defensive glass. Okay. So Duke, I don't know how often they're going to be able to create second chance opportunities or hit the glass. I think that's a key for Duke, but Vermont's very good on the glass. And they can be balanced, Vermont. They can be balanced in terms of minutes and also in relation to point production, right? You mentioned Shamir Bogues. TJ Long, I think, is leading them in points. Don't forget about Aaron Deloney. So those are the three key personnel for Vermont, but they get contributions. I mean, it might just be cardio. I don't know, but they get contributions from a lot of other people on the team. So I mentioned a little bit about Duke having to hit the offensive glass, but, and I think that's going to fall a lot on Filipowski, you know, Jared McCain, Mark Mitchell. I don't know how many minutes Ryan Young's getting these days. I don't know how many minutes Shire really goes to his bench, but Ryan Young's going to have to hit the glass. And then you nailed it. What's the most frightening thing? It's those transition threes. I didn't specify in my notes transition threes, but threes from Jeremy Roach and McCain. I think they need to be looking for like a 37% from three type of night. And I think they'll win comfortably.
Yeah, I'm with you on that. And I think you touched on it earlier, but the firepower, ultimately, Vermont is a good defensive team at the mid-major level. I don't know how long they can contain this Duke team before they really open it up. It's a top 10 offense. I do like, however, again, I'm still thinking about just these different ways that Vermont can at least make it close or make it competitive. And Duke has struggled some against teams that can match their physicality on the glass. You look at the last game in Cameron. I mean, they got the last game in Cameron against UNC, they got out-rebounded by 11. And I mean, they have more size than UNC. Kyle Filipowski is a 7-footer. Armando Bacot's 6'11". Mark Mitchell, I believe, is 6'8". Harrison Ingram is a generous 6'7". Like, granted, once you get to the perimeter unit, it gets they're a little bit smaller. But you would think that, you know, they'd be able to use that size advantage to always have a massive rebounding. Positive margin, but yeah, even against a smaller front court in Vermont, maybe they can control the glass a little bit, keep Duke from those second chance points to slow down that offense. But yeah, it just to me, it feels like the dam is eventually going to break. McCain or Roach, like we've been saying, they're going to hit one of those threes. Maybe even Mark Mitchell throws up one of his hideous shots that goes in. I don't know how that dude's jumper ever goes in. As someone who also has an ugly jumper when I play pickup, I was in a tournament, a 3-on-3 tournament on Sunday, and couldn't hit anything. I'm like, man, why do some guys get all the luck that they're 6'8 and bouncy and can have an ugly jump shot and goes in? I digress. But yeah, I just think that's eventually Duke's talent is going to win out throughout the Shire era. Really going back to the latter years of the Coach K era when he stacked his rosters with one and dones. It's just like, there's too much talent, generally speaking, to be upset by a mid-major. The rosters that lost to Mercer, the rosters that lost to Lehigh, those are dead and gone, like the T.I. and Justin Timberlake song.
There it is. You know how much I love intertwining music, theater, movies. Keep it going. This is great. And you know what? Shooters shoot. So keep shooting in your pickup games. Now, I agree totally with the talent discrepancy, the roster, and just the sheer talent, right? But are you a little concerned with Duke about the want to or the desire? Like, I'm telling you, it was a bit alarming to not see them show up at home against their arch rival with a lot on the line. It was alarming to see them not show up against a bad NC State team with a lot on the line. And you're now carrying this over into, and remember, I want folks to remember, when you play conference champions, no matter what level, for the most part, like, I'm not sitting here saying Wagner's is a world beater, but like, Vermont has proven year in and year out, they win this conference. They're not some complete pushover. You got to come correct, I think, if you're Duke.
I'm with you. I do question their want to in general. I question like even the mental fortitude to make a deep run. I just don't think it's going to come back to bite them this early.
Fair enough.
Yeah. With that being said, we're going to get into score predictions in a second, but first I want to give a shout out to one of the sponsors of the Sleepers Media YouTube channel. It's MyBookie. So if you're still on the hunt for a sports book to call home, bet the nonstop action of March Madness with MyBookie. Enter bracket contest for a chance to take home prizes of up to $25,000 or pick from a huge selection of straight bets, props, and odds and boosts. Whatever your style, MyBookie makes it easy to play your way and get paid. So if you sign up now, take advantage of the generous welcome offer to score a massive first deposit bonus of up to $1,000. All you have to do is claim promo code SLEEPERS. Fun doesn't stop there. Get up-to-the-minute odds, free bets, and expert predictions to help you decide who to put your money on. So use promo code SLEEPERS to secure your limited-time welcome bonus today. Subbi, I'm going to turn it to you. We both said we think Duke gets this done. What do you think the scoring margin is going to be?
Okay, so I'm thinking we're going to look at a score line of – can I give you the actual score or do you want the margin? I might be able to get away with just the difference.
Give me either.
All right, I'll go with the score. I'll keep it simple. I'm going to say 71-58 Duke. I think it'll be close for more than just the first 4 minutes. And then Duke will end up pulling away, end up winning by about 13 or so. So I'm saying 71-58. What about you?
Oh, man, it's not in Cameron. If it was in Cameron, I'm just like – well, duh, they're neutral site games, but I'm just like trying
No, it's just funny how like that Cameron dictates how they're gonna play.
It's just like looking at their schedule, every mid-major team that they've played, they've scored at least 80 on, but they've all been at home. So maybe they are a little tight. I still see them getting to 80. I'm gonna say the final score is 80-65.
Okay. Here's one last thing, Riley, before we get on out of here. One thing Vermont does have going for them, actually, a few things. They got a pretty good three-point shooter with the first name TJ. They're going up against an ACC team. Don't worry about Syracuse being in the Big East. 13-4. The game's being played in the Northeast. If you're into that sort of thing, if you're into those spooky little things, you got those things going for you, okay, Vermont?
Well said. No better way to end this. Tune into the Sleepers Media YouTube channel because regardless of what happens, Subbi and I will be back breaking down this game and many more. So enjoy the lead up to the tournament and enjoy those first couple days of games.